their pop song, singing to that highway song. Got a little naive smile, the kind that drives you out. Nothing like playing with fire, brings boy to life. Be where the fuse you light, you're your dynamite. You made my day when you walked into town beside me, whispered with your eyes, let's go. You made me say, what's your name, girl, you're lonely. Can I call you if I ever go down this road? And I can't seem to find the thing I want to see.
The following is a presentation of the Belly Up Sports Media Network.
In the morning, 14 minutes and 20 seconds worth of sports talk to get you through your daily commute. Hot takes, recaps, best bets, and a little humor to get your day going in the right direction. Sit back, grab your coffee, and let's get into it.
All right, 14:20 in the morning for this 23rd day of May 2023. Today's show, as every show this month, brought to you by SeatGeek.com and the SeatGeek app. Use promo code 1420POD at SeatGeek.com today and save yourself $20 on your first purchase for a sporting event, concert, or a show, whatever you're planning on going to this summer. Plan ahead and go and get some tickets at SeatGeek.com and save yourself $20 in the process. Remember, we are part of the Belly Up Sports Network, Belly Up Media. Go to BellyUp.com and check out all their great sports content, articles, and other podcasts after you check ours out, obviously, at bellyup.com. And thank you very much for being a part of our thank you for making us part of your day each and every day here at 1420 World Headquarters. My apologies, everybody. Didn't get a show out for since, I think, Thursday night. Me and Dave did one, and then we didn't do any 1420 in the morning. We didn't have a last call on Sunday night. Been a little preoccupied on the baseball field. A lot going on around here in Lethbridge, Alberta. Great weekend of shows. And then last night, I got a surprise visit from my brother from Victoria. He showed up out of nowhere last night, and I was quite the surprise. I was sitting over at Brown's having a frosty pre-show beverage, because me and Dave were supposed to record last night, and it just never happened because my brother said he was at my front door, and he came over to Brown's there, and we hoisted a few beers last night and had some laughs, and with my mom and his wife and Deanne, she showed up too, and it was a nice little night and an unexpected surprise. So Dave and I didn't get a show out last night. We'll get one out to the masses very shortly. Anyways, there it is. There's the biography of why you didn't put any shows out. Not that anybody, I don't think, cares, but there's a reason if you do care. I hope you do. But anyways, it was a great weekend of baseball here in Lethbridge, Alberta at Old Spit Stadium. Great ending of the CCBC season, the Canadian College Baseball Conference. It's a great league that they have here, 8 teams, I think it is. I should probably know that since I'm an umpire in that league, but it was a great tournament all in all. The weather was great, a little bit smoky on Friday and Saturday because of the wildfires are still raging up in northern Alberta and the wind shift and everything else, but it's a great weekend of baseball that was definitely a culmination of a great season, that the unexpected season, one of the more competitive seasons over the years that they've had in that league. But it was an interesting to see, and being an observer on a baseball field where you don't have a vesting interest in who wins and who loses the ball game, no matter what people say, umpires, we don't care who wins or loses these games. But it was very interesting to see the raw emotion of these players throughout the weekend, and the way the game is supposed to be played, and the way sports is supposed to be played, and not with all the noise that comes out with minor sports and amateur sports and everything else. But we'll get to that in half a second. The college sports experience is something to watch, and no matter what level, whether it be NCAA or Canadian college or U Sport here in Canada or JUCO or whatever it might be, in my opinion, it's the purest form of sport that there is, because you don't have a bunch of kids who might be playing there for their last time in their careers. They might be playing they're not playing in general for contracts. Most of these guys know that the end of their careers are coming to an end, and they're utilizing their athletic abilities to get themselves an education, and they're utilizing it to the networking and everything else that it comes with college sports. And it's such a great thing to have, that you get away from all the noise of amateur sports, and you see a lot of the emotion of the games that come out through the coaches and comes out through the players. And it's rarely a negative thing. Yes, there was a few head-butting situations over the weekend, nothing too major that happened throughout the tournament at Spitz there, but it was a great emotional weekend. And you saw players who cared about each other and they cared about winning for not only for their teammates, but for their college and for the people that they hang out with on a daily basis. I got to know a few of the kids from PBA, the Prairie Baseball Academy, throughout this season, because we were around Lloyd Nolan Yard a lot. So you got to know these kids a lot, and the emotion they got into the season. It didn't end the way they hoped, with a loss on, I think it was on Sunday night, that the game that came down to the wire, an 11-10 loss at bottom of ninth. They had a chance to win that game. But you see a lot of these things, that the players playing for each other, and they're the players playing for their friends, their teammates, their classmates, guys that they hang out with a lot, guys that they aren't forced to hang out with, guys that are playing not for an academy, not for some contrived team that didn't exist before this season, not some contrived team that may not exist next week, and not some travel team that their parents paid for them to get on, or paid somebody for to be on that. But they were playing for their friends. And you saw that a lot over the weekend with the way that they were playing for each other. And it was so refreshing to see that it was a bunch of guys on every team that was playing. They knew that they were playing maybe that what might have been their last game. They might have been playing their last game of organized baseball. There might have been they might have been playing their last game of any baseball at all, because in general they don't have many rec leagues that I know of. There are a few that pop up here and there, but in general, when you're done playing baseball, you're basically done. That's it. Yeah, you can go and play slow pitch, but it's not the same, right? It's organized slow pitch, and if anybody takes slow pitch competitively, you're doing slow pitch wrong. There's my thoughts for the day. People know my opinions on slow pitch. But in general, you have a bunch of kids, or young men, I should say, they're playing the game the right way. They're playing hard. They're playing maybe to go down south and get a college scholarship or partial scholarship down south to an American college. They might be playing the odd guy out there, might be looking for a minor pro contract or a independent league contract or something along those lines. But in general, most of the kids, most of the guys playing this weekend knew that it was going to be their last weekend of competitive baseball in their lives. They knew that the next at bat might be their last. They knew that the next pitch that they got, or the next ball that they got hit to them, was going to be their last one. So the extra effort that was there throughout the weekend from every team was something to watch and was something to behold. And it was a lot of fun to be out there and be a part of. Like I said, when you don't have a vesting interest, who wins, and you can sit back and watch a little bit. No, I wasn't just sitting back watching. I was officiating games. But sometimes when you're in the stands between your games as an official, you watch the fans and you watch the parents and you watch the players and the conversations that people are having and the fun that these guys were having and competing for what might be the last time, because that's something that gets lost with guys, that they miss the competition of being a high-end athlete. I guess that you miss that competition and going out there and playing hard and playing for a championship and playing for something, because that's one thing you lose. You don't get a chance to do very often when you hang up your hockey equipment, or you hang up your gloves or your cleats, whatever it may be, whatever sport you're playing, and you don't get a chance to do that in college sports. No matter if it's football or baseball or hockey, it gives guys one last chance when they get a little bit more mature and a little bit older to realize that, hey, this is it, and this is something that I wanted to do, that this has been a lot of fun, but they know deep down inside that they're not going to be able to do again. And it's refreshing to see these guys play for each other and not to some, like I said, some contrived travel team that doesn't really exist anymore, or didn't really exist in their brains before. And it was some guy trying to make a few bucks off their backs and their hard work and something that just doesn't go. But these kids are from all ages 18 to 23, 24 years old, and they know the business, and they know that they've reached the pinnacle of their sport, and they've had a great time doing it. And this weekend was a culmination of that happening. And it was fun to be a part of. It was fun to see. There were some great plays, some not so great plays. There was some comebacks, some real close comebacks. There were some wins. There were some losses. There were some tears that were being shed. And another thing that I noticed a lot is that these young men, when they knew that it was over, they saw that it was over, and their parents, some of these guys are 23, 24 years old, and the tears that were coming out of their eyes, no matter what, even though there was only one team was ended up winning the whole thing. We'll get to them in half a second, but it was interesting to watch them and watch the parents, reaction to their boys getting emotional a little bit, and the culmination of their careers and everything that they've been through over the years. And it was interesting to watch that parents were watching their boy play for the last time in something that they've been either being a good parent, a bad parent, a good sports parent, a bad sports parent. You don't know what it was like, because every parent to a person was a good sports parent, and they were supportive of their kid. There was cheering for their kid's team. There was cheering for good plays. There wasn't any worrying about what the other guy was doing. There wasn't any worrying about if the academy or some evaluator was there watching their kid or making sure that their kid was making the right play. They weren't worried about scouts in the stands. They were worried about seeing their boy play for the last time, and they were worried about the actual outcome of the game and not what the stat line was. And a lot of parents, they worry too much when their kids are 12, 13, 14 years old about what the stat line is of their kids, and they could care less if their kid's team wins or not. But this weekend was 100%. It was refreshing to watch these guys play for each other, and not just the team that won, but every team to a man that was playing. It was funny on Sunday night when the game between Victoria, I was on third base between Victoria and Calgary. I said to the Victoria third base coach, good guy, which I can't remember his name, doesn't much matter right now, but I shook his hand, as they all do before the game started, and I said, hey man, if you'd have told me it was Victoria and Calgary going to be in the play-in game to get the A-side final, I would have, or the championship final, I'd have said, you guys are crazy, because I saw Victoria lose 26-0 earlier on this season here in Lethbridge in a game that didn't go so well for Victoria. They got off the bus, and there was a lot of stories going on, but it was very interesting to see a team that played hard, and Victoria played hard all weekend long, and they had a good bunch of kids, a nice bunch of kids. I call them kids because I'm not a kid, obviously. I'm twice of all their ages, so I can call them kids, I guess. But it was great to see that they put in the effort, and that the heartbreak wasn't great to see the heartbreak they had yesterday, but the effort they put in. They were down 7-1. They came back. They made a game at 8-7 final. I think the final score was, came down last out with Calgary last night. And it was just a fun tournament to watch. And the thing about these games, it's you see something that these guys, that these players, they may never see each other again. They may never have a chance to be as a group. In fact, I can guarantee you that most of these guys, they went their merry ways. Some guys have to go they have to report to their college summer teams. That some are just going home to the season's over, because season's over well after the school year is done. So they probably had their own vehicles and they just went home. That was it. So as a group, they will never be together again, you wouldn't think. But it's something that maybe a few of them will sit around in 10 years, 20 years, 30 years from now, and they'll have this memory forever that they won a championship. It's, you know, it's not the World Series, it's not the NCAA World Series. It's a championship that as a group they came together and they won. And it's something that they can, even the team that lost, they can go back and look at something and say, you know what, that was pretty cool. That was, we almost pulled this thing off, and no one gave us a chance. It was something that we can hold our heads up high. It's not much solace here getting something from the 1420 podcast to talk about that, but it's something that every team that gets together that late in their lives, and not be playing for anything but their friends, their teammates, and actually for the jersey on their backs for once. That doesn't happen a lot in sports, because a lot of time in amateur sports, guys aren't playing. They're playing for their own stat line. They're not playing for a team. But I think to a man, every team this weekend at the CCBC Championship was playing to win something, and playing for their friends, playing for their teammates, playing for their school. And because these guys, they hang out a lot. They're together a lot throughout the season. And they you could tell that they were playing for their friends and their teammates. Like, there might be some, every team has people who don't get along, but when you're on the field, those kids were playing hard for each other, and it was refreshing to watch. So yeah, it was a great weekend all along. It was a fun tournament to be had. It was a lot of fun. I wish more people would have come and showed up, but the weather and long weekend, people don't get the chance. But if you ever have a chance in the upcoming years, go to a university sports event, because it's great. It's great drama. It's great to watch, because most of these kids, especially here in Canada, they aren't going on to bigger and better things. This is pretty much it, and the culmination of a baseball career that they thought may have been a big league venture. Their parents might have thought it had been a big league venture, but in general, when you get to a Canadian college, university, this is pretty much it. Like, some guys do move on to different things, but these guys are putting in the effort night in, night out, and it's fun to watch no matter what sport it is. And it's the way the sport should be played. They play hard. They play the right way, whatever is the right way. But they play for each other, and it was really fun to watch. And I hope more parents go and watch this and show their kids, or kids show their parents, actually, more so that this is, we're playing for fun, and this is why I play the game. Because I'll never get another chance to do this again, and it was refreshing to see, and it was a great weekend of baseball. No one was making a ton of money off these kids. No one's making a ton of money at the gate. No one's selling jerseys and hats and t-shirts. Like, nobody's trying to make a buck off these things. It was pure baseball. It was a lot of fun to watch. It was good baseball. There was, like I said, there were some errors, there were some great plays, there were some home runs, there was a grand slam. There everything you wanted to see in a baseball game, and it was fun to watch. And those kids that won a championship, it's great. And there wasn't none of that other noise that happens in amateur sport with the academies and everything else. It was just great to watch that these people were having a good time. Teammates were, like, after every game, the last game of every team, with double elimination, and when teams were knocked out, you had teammates hugging teammates, you had parents hugging parents hugging their kids, you had parents hugging fellow teammates, and they were just watching the emotion of it and the tears and everything else. And I think some parents go, you know what, all those years of yelling and screaming and everything else, was it really worth it over the years and being mad and spending all that money when this is what we should have been watching the games more than we should have been arguing about where my kid's playing, where little Jimmy ranks on the totem pole of amateur sports or everything else. And but it was sport the way sport was meant to be played, and it was a great thing to be a part of. And I don't think I got any calls right. I'm sure some of the managers and everything else might think anything wrong, but I had a pretty good weekend on the field. It was a lot of fun being a part of, and like, once again, thank you to the Perry Baseball Academy for having us in there around the ballpark all year long to help out umpires and help your guys out a little bit to get knowledge of strike zone and everything else. But anyways, to end this show off, we'll get to the birthdays and things. I want to say congratulations to the University of Calgary Dinos and head coach Cam Williams, the CCBC champion this weekend. Good championship victory. I didn't think you guys were going to pull it off when the tournament started, like I said, but Cam, you have that team with some good emotion and a good bunch of kids, like I can call them kids, a great bunch of kids who aren't controversial. They were having fun. They were playing the game the right way. It did not go unnoticed to the umpiring crew that you guys were having a lot of fun, and that might have put you guys over the top. Your bench guys were screaming and hollering and having a good time. Your bullpen was singing a bunch of songs out there from the bullpen trying to get some runs and everything else. So it was a lot of fun to be around you guys throughout the weekend. If there was a call you didn't like, you questioned it, but there was never an argument. You just went your merry way. Your players, to a man, they didn't complain wholeheartedly. Your catcher, Eric, good kid. I like working behind him. He's a lot of fun to be around. So congratulations once again to Ken Williams of the CCBC champion Calgary Dinosaurs on winning your, I think it was your first league championship. Congratulations to a man. And it was great to see. And I also, if anybody from Victoria listens to this, the Victoria Golden Tide, I saw them lose a 26-0 game this year. And I didn't think you guys would be in the final, but boy, oh boy, you guys put a scare into Calgary yesterday. You were down 7-1 and came back to make it 8-7. It was crazy to watch that game. It was a lot of fun to watch that game. And congratulations on your season. Ethan, congratulations on the season coming back. We had a little set to back in April, but I hope you we get along later on. We shook hands this weekend, so that was good. But no, it was a great weekend for the CCBC. And whoever listened to this show, make sure you guys get out to different college baseball things around Canada, around the United States, and watch these teams play, because it's the way the game should be played. And there's no contracts, there's no parents, it's just kids playing baseball, having a good time, and that's the way the game should be played. And I hope more parents realize that's the way the game should be played. Anyways, there's my rant for the day here in 1420 in the morning. Remember to go to righteousfelon.com for 15% off their craft beef jerky. Righteous Felon is the official supplier of beef jerky to the Belly Up network of shows. Anyways, on this day in 2010, the Chicago Blackhawks defeated the San Jose Sharks 4-2 to sweep the Western Conference Finals in front of 22,254 people United Center in Chicago. San Jose held a 2-0 lead until halfway through the second period before Brent Seabrook scored and Dave Buller tied the game up late in the middle frame. Dustin Byfuglien scored the eventual game winner on the power play at 14:05 of the third period. 17 days later, the Chicago Blackhawks would win the Stanley Cup on Patrick Kane's overtime goal versus the Philadelphia Flyers. I was actually at Dodger Stadium watching that, watching the Dodger game. They had this the game on the big screen when Kane scored that goal. I went to a bar in downtown Hollywood and watched the celebration and everything else. But it was fun to watch those Chicago teams. Yeah, they had some controversy after so, but those 2010 through 14 Chicago Blackhawk teams were some of the greatest hockey teams ever assembled. Too bad they couldn't salary cap and everything else that happened. But congratulations on this day in 2010, the Chicago Blackhawks. And actually, happy 44th birthday to Brian Campbell, born on this day in 1979 in Strathroy, Ontario. Campbell was a member of those 2010 Stanley Cup winning Hawks team, where he got five total points in the playoffs. Campbell was drafted in the sixth round, 156 overall, to the Buffalo Sabres, and played in 17 NHL seasons, 1,082 games, with 87 goals and 417 points. Or 417 assists for 504 points and 277 penalty minutes. Won the Lady Bing Award in 2011 when he amassed 6 penalty minutes as a member of the Florida Panthers. So happy birthday to Brian Campbell. Anyways, make sure you guys, thanks for listening to the show. Once again, we're getting back on our regular schedule. Summertime's a little bit tough, but we'll get things straightened out. We'll put it up on Facebook, Twitter. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel today. It's a long, drawn-out process. Make sure you guys listen to the podcast, wherever you get your podcast. Share it with people out there. Let people know about the 1420 podcast and what we're trying to get accomplished here. We appreciate all the support we've gotten. We were trying to get some bigger numbers, but it's a little bit tough right now, but with people not wanting to be inside during it and have me in their ears during the warm weather out there. You got a lot going on, but thank you very much for being a part of the 1420 podcast. And make sure you go to our online shop. It'll be in the show's notes. Get yourself some 1420 gear and 1420 in the morning gear, Hey Blue gear, and 1420 podcast gear. It's all there for your pleasure, and get some shirts and go support the 1420 podcast. Anyways, there's your show for this morning. Me and Dave, I think we're hooking up tonight. Haven't really decided what's going to happen there yet, but as always, I'll see you tomorrow morning for sure on 1420 in the morning. But as always, hey, it doesn't matter where you are. It's who you're with. It's who you're with. Have a good day, folks. We'll talk to you tomorrow.
SeatGeek is the ticketing app for fans like the high five strangers guy. Game-winning interception. First down. Just a nice, solid tackle. If you're in arm's length, you will be swapping skin with this extrovert. You see, he knows SeatGeek got him a great deal on tickets, so he can focus on what he does best, smacking palms. SeatGeek handles the tickets to sports, concerts, and more, so fans can fan.
You just listened to the 1420 Sports Bar Podcast. Four beer with sports talk and a whole lot more. We are part of the Belly Up Media Network. Let's get into it.